Well, the pressure test in the MasterChef kitchen was tough on two fronts for Melanie. Not only was the clock ticking, but she had to cook with gluten for the first time in 5 years. And as a celiac, that proved to be quite challenging.
Obviously, you've got another set of challenges. You're unable to test that because you're gluten intolerant.
It's been a really long time since I dabbled with wheat pastry,
right, okay.
So...
Breathe, Mel, it's all good.
I'm definitely trying to remember what Josh's pastry was like. It wasn't thick. The recipe says it should be 2 mils thick, which seems insanely thin.
It's definitely not 2 mils.
It's been more than 5 years since I cooked with gluten flour.
The dish that least resembled Josh's was yours, Melanie.
And Melanie joins us now live from Melbourne. Melanie, this was a bit of a nightmare challenge. It was a pressure test. On top of that, you're unable to taste the dish, obviously, because you're
that
celiac.
Must have been so hard.
I'd imagine that's the last thing you have to do before you put any meals out, you know? So you kind of had to entirely trust the recipe and not taste it. Do you think it would have been a different outcome if you could have tasted the dish?
Oh, I mean, who knows? It's very easy to say, sure, I might have done better in a different challenge, but, I mean, who really knows? It's a pressure test for a reason. The recipes we have to follow are always insanely difficult. So, who knows? I mean, it was definitely really difficult, but, yeah, it's hard to say.
I'll answer it for you, yes.
And you would have been quite sick if you had have tasted the dish, right?
Yeah, absolutely. I actually get very violently ill if I eat any gluten.
Wow.
And... that's not even, you know, to think about the long-term effects that can, you know, harm someone with celiac disease if they ingest it. So
you came onto MasterChef to challenge yourself. Aside from the four-hour pressure test last night, what was the biggest kind of challenge you faced, and what did you take away from the experience?
I think it was really hard. The biggest challenge was probably being away from home, especially like in the COVID environment. Everybody else, like we film over Christmas, and everybody else was able to have a bit of a break where they went home and, you know, saw their family. And because I was the only contestant from Perth, I was the only one that couldn't do that. So I mean, it was fine at the time, but I think having a little bit of being able to get a bit of a refresh and get some perspective maybe, might have made me approach the competition a little bit differently, but, you know, it is what it is, and that was okay.
Yeah, I wondered, being a celiac, if you would have expected something like this to come across at some stage of the competition. However, I'd imagine you're quite proud that you got to showcase all the gluten-free food on the show, especially on a show like MasterChef.
Yeah, definitely. It's funny because to begin with, I was really thinking about what it meant for me to have that validation of, like, to really explore the gluten-free food and to show that it can compete at that level. But then as the show has aired, my perspective on that has really changed. I've realised that it's been so important for other people with celiac disease and gluten intolerance to feel represented on a scale like this. And the response has been really overwhelming in a very positive way. So it's been huge and really, really nice to see.
Oh, did you love meeting Maggie Beer as well? What a cooking legend is she?
Absolutely. It was so exciting to meet Maggie. I think I just kind of almost fell on a puddle on the floor. It was, she's
Look
an Aussie
face.
Icon.
Oh, that's just so gorgeous. You're so excited. Were you hoping she was going to walk through the doors?
Oh, I mean, I'm just so glad I got a chance to meet her before I was eliminated, because she's an absolute ray of sunshine, and I've been watching her for, you know, as long as I can remember. I learned a lot about cooking from Maggie.
Aww.
That's fantastic. And
she,
you know,
would
a lot
love
of people,
to hear that too.
Yeah, she would, yeah. And a lot of people will learn a lot from seeing you cooking on this show as well. You're a PhD student. How did you manage to find your love for cooking? I mean, was MasterChef always a dream?
Yeah, kind of. I've been cooking since I was really young, and it all kind of changed when I was diagnosed with celiac disease, but after a little while I just kind of saw it as a challenge that I really wanted to overcome, and I just, you know, tried to really make it happen.
Oh, good on you, Melanie. And rumour has it that you've got a cookbook in the works. That's exciting. Is it true first?
Yeah, I do. I have a publishing contract for my gluten-free cookbook. So I'm super excited about that. And, I'll be posting updates about it and progress on my Instagram. So feel free to follow along at The Very Hungry Celiac if you're keen.
Superb.
How good are you? MasterChef Australia fans and favourites continues tonight at 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play On Demand. Melanie, thank you so much for joining us. We're so glad you had a great time in the kitchen, the MasterChef kitchen, and we can't wait to catch your new cookbook as well. Well done.
Thanks a lot, guys.
Bye.
Good on you, Melanie.